All right. I'm going to read two things. One is a poem I wrote almost 30 years ago. At that time, and it's very ironic in the light of all of this, that this event is for, at that time, the state senator of New Mexico, Christine Donisthorpe, who was also on the school board of Bloomfield, New Mexico, oversaw the burning of a book called Bless Me Ultima, a classic Chicano work by Rudolfo Anaya. So I'm going to read a poem that I wrote in response to that. And then I'm going to read a poem that I translated that was written by a very young Ecuadorian poet named Carla Badillo Coronado. Carla will be here next month at the San Francisco International Poetry Festival. She's been invited, and you will hear the poem completely read by her. I'm not truncating the reading. I'll read a bit in Spanish, and then I'll read the total poem that in the translation. I'll read a bit in Spanish for you to get the taste of it, but I want you all to come to hear the whole thing read in Spanish by Carla. She is an extraordinary poet. She's very young, she's 26 years old. She won the most prodigious prize, a literary prize, in Ecuadorian history. The first one won by a woman also this past year. So, all right, let me do this first, okay? This is called Book Burning. When Maya Kumsky and comrades burned Shakespeare's books in 1919, there was no heat. The people were freezing and starving, and tinder and wood were gone. Altogether different were the Nazi burnings or the New York courts of the works of Wilhelm Reich, or the New Mexico state senators of Chicano Rodolfo Anaya's novel. Those are gestures of an infamy that even unexcavated codices whose hydrocarbons remember, accused to infinity. And now this poem of Carlo. I'll read a couple of the sections in Spanish so you get the taste of it. El día en que tuve que asistir a una iglesia en Arizona. Tuve que regresar de Durango a Fountain Hills para recoger mis cosas de la casa de Flora. Apenas me quedaban horas para ir a Phoenix y allí tomar un vuelo hacia Los Ángeles y finalmente a Ecuador. De Fountain Hills a Phoenix no hay buses, ni trenes, ni caballos públicos. Necesitas tu propio auto para salir del pueblo. Yo no tengo auto, desde luego. Solo soy un forastera atrapada en el desierto. Tenía dos opciones. Llamar taxi, que me cobraría $100, o esperar a que Flora me llevara en su auto. I continue. Flora Cristiana Conservadora Republicana no miraba con buenos ojos mi hazañas desde luego. Si hubiese tenido el dinero, llamaba al taxi, pero no quedó más remedio que ir con ella. Antes de salir, Flora me advirtió que primero asistiríamos a su grupo de oración en la iglesia del siguiente pueblo. No tuve opción. En Scotland, el calor era soberbio. Y yo parecía un oso polar perdido en el Sahara, porque llevaba encima una tonelada de ropa para burlar el control de peso de maletas. Ya en la iglesia, el grupo de señores colocó un vídeo en el que aparecía una mujer dando consejos para ser mejores, y de fondo imágenes de la tierra prometida. Yo solo pensaba en qué diablos hacía allí, en medio de esas siervas rubias del Señor, todas felices tomando apuntes y de rato en rato comiendo un bocadillo. Al final, una de las mujeres se levantó y pidió que nos tomáramos de las manos para orar por los niños pobres de este mundo. ¿Qué diablos saben ellas de eso?, pensé. También querían orar para que los palestinos parecen su brutalidad frente a Israel. Deberían revisar los números de muertos palestinos en Gaza, pensé, y por último orar para que McCain ganara la presidencia junto a su inteligencia binomia Palin. Fue ahí cuando sentí ganas de vomitar. Me sentí sucia e insultada y salí de la iglesia. Ahora estoy aquí, derritiéndome junto a un cactus, pero prefiero ir a Phoenix subida en un coyote antes que morir reventada el hígado. Definitivamente no. No quiero estar en un círculo de mujeres ricachonas viendo el patético video sobre cómo ganarme el cielo, elogiando a falsos beceros, orando por los que no tienen alimento y en cada receso atragantarme con caros bocadillos comprados con el dinero del buen rebaño. The day I had to attend church in Arizona by Carla Badillo Coronado. I had to return from Durango to Fountain Hills to collect my things from Flora's house. There was barely enough time to go to Phoenix and then catch a flight to Los Angeles and finally one to Ecuador. From Fountain Hills to Phoenix, there are no buses, trains, or public horses. You need your own car to get out of town. I don't have a car, of course. I'm just a foreigner trapped in a desert. There are two options. Call a taxi that'll cost me $100, or hope that Flora would take me in her car. Flora, a Christian conservative Republican, of course, didn't approve of my exploits. If I'd had the money, I'd have called a cab, but I had no other recourse than to go with her. Before leaving, Flora advised me that first, we'd attend the prayer group in a church in the next town. I didn't have a choice. In Scotland, the heat was superb, and I appeared like a polar bear in the Sahara because I was carrying a ton of clothes to scoff at the weight control of my suitcases. Now, in the church, the group of ladies set up a video in which a woman appeared giving advice on how to be better, and at bottom, images of the promised land. I just was thinking about how devils work there amid those blonde servants of the Lord, all of them happy, taking notes at intervals, nibbling on tidbits. Finally, one of the women got up and bid us take each other's hands to pray for the poor kids of the third world. The devils should only know about this, I thought. Also, they wanted to pray that the Palestinians stop their brutality against Israel. They should review the numbers of dead Palestinians in Gaza, I thought. And finally, to pray so that McCain wins the presidency together with his co-nominee, the intelligent Palin. That was when I felt like vomiting, felt dirty and insulted, and got myself out of that church. Now I'm here melting next to a cactus, but I prefer going to Phoenix mounted on a coyote before dying of a burst liver. Definitely not. I don't want to be part of a circle of disgustingly rich women watching a pathetic video about how to get to heaven praising false idols, praying for those who don't have food, and at each recess choking me with expensive sandwiches bought with the flock's money.